to Vale Road, we're doing towards the Vale.
Yeah.
Well, we took the quickest route by the looks of it. And I think that's a pat on the back for ourselves, we didn't get lost for once. Well, we weren't exactly sure all the way where we were going, we just thought we were going the right direction, didn't we? Okay. Well, the vegetation starting to be interesting already. See the rough timbers?
Yeah.
That's very rare that Australians have a wood like that. South Australia, there's not much left of it.
Yeah, it's a bit like Spring Gully. It's so that
Well, we're definitely on the minor country road. We have lost the middle white line.
Right.
Means keep on your own side, prepare to dodge everything. Oh, look at that white line there. I tell people which side of the corner. Locals have a bad habit of cutting corners. That's one of the most important areas left to cut if it's plants in South Australia. Has all the major Drosea species, and I think including Pyrifolia. And as we know too, it has Polypomflex tenia, and we'll be surprised if we find other stuff around.
Oh, this is it? I think that's it.
Right,
I'm
let's
not
go and find somewhere to park.
I'm going for a close up on Lincoln. You got number 7 down there.
Actually, if you look at it too, it's
going to be out of your port. Oh. And there's a little bit all over the ground here.
But you notice there's only a narrow band, about this wide.
How wide?
It looks like about a band about this wide going across, which is very classic for a serpentine intrusion.
Right.
Serpentinic material is that what they call an ultramafic rock. It comes from right down the bottom of the mantle and usually gets extruded in a metamorphic or a igneous process.
Right.
The actual areas of a pure serpentine are very, very rare. Right. Possibly only 7 sites in the world where pure serpentine actually gets to the surface. Basically gets squeezed up like toothpaste.
Right.
From geological forces. Yeah, this is it's an unstable rock, it breaks down to olivine and stuff like that. Down to schist and mica and clays.
Oh, okay.
That's the end product of it.
Well, it's
very high in nickel, manganese, iron, and heavier metals.
Chromium, cobalt, copper.
Yeah, but not so much cobalt. Anyway, shall we?
Yeah.
Time to go.